Many of you know him personally for building the Wells Fargo Center. But I know Mr. Snider as the man that honestly saved my life. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Ed Snider.
I never imagined the impact that the Flyers would have on the community when we started in 1967. The Philly has been really wonderful to me, and I get a great thrill and a great pleasure giving back to the community. And I really want to thank everyone here for this very special award, and I want to congratulate all the rest of the honorees here tonight. Thank you.
The team did have names like Hope Solo, Abby Wambach, and Alex Morgan, but none really is any bigger than Dale Rand's own Carly Lloyd, the winner of the 2012 Philadelphia Sports Writers Association Team of the Year. Carly?
It's been quite a run for us. Obviously, in the 2011 World Cup, we lost to Japan in the final. I missed a PK. It was just a sour taste in all of our mouths. So we wanted nothing more than to get redemption in the Olympic final against Japan, and we happened to do that.
We salute him for his perseverance and his courage in the wake of all his obstacles and challenges as a person without sight, both in his personal and his professional life. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome the winner of the 2013 Philadelphia Sports Writers Association Most Courageous Athlete Award from Mount Laurel, New Jersey, Mario Tabia.
When he told me I would be receiving this award, I looked on the internet and I saw some of the past winners, that names like Bobby Clark, Tommy John, Tom Dempsey, and even Ben Hogan. You know, all terrific stories about men who's overcome unbelievable hardship or disabilities to excel in their sport. And I'm truly honored to be in that category.
I was accused of nepotism. They said that he was only on the team because I was his dad. Nothing could be further from the truth. He was not on the team because I was his dad. He was on the team because he was married to his mother. If I wanted to eat, I'd eat.
Pretty cool to have the two best shortstops in Philly's history sitting at the same table.
And every night Carlton pitched in April, we knew it was going to be a quick game, so we'd go across the street and watch the Broad Street Bullies play the last period. And believe me, they put on a show every single night. So I want to thank them because it made my life a lot of fun.
While leading his team to five straight postseason playoffs and two World Series, Rollins has indelibly etched his name among the greatest players in Philly's history.
Tied him in gold gloves, so I'm still working on knocking him off the pedestal that he's, although he did say I was a little better, but, you know, I still look up to him. And when I'm not doing good, believe me, he's the first one to text me. Right after Charlie benches me. So we'll make sure that doesn't happen again.
You know, like, but I think, you know, like, at the same time, you know, like, yeah, by the way, I saw Jimmy Rollins ran out, the first thing he ran out all year.
Same time, you know, like, Jimmy's a tremendous player. And, of course, Cole Hamels is a great pitcher. And I enjoy every minute I spend with Jimmy and Cole.
The Philadelphia Sports Writers Association named Cole and Heidi Hamels truly teammates in philanthropy with our Humanitarian of the Year award.
Seeing the joy on kids' faces and teachers and a community, that's really is probably going to be the everlasting moments that I will take.
Like Ruben, you know, he's had so many great off seasons. This isn't one of them. I guess he ran out of money after he signed me, I guess, yeah.
Mike Trout, the pride of Millville, the pride of South Jersey, the pride of the Philadelphia area, is the Philadelphia Sports Writers Pro Athlete of the Year.
It's very special to me for this award. Thank my family, my friends, see some friends in the corner, and Angels organization for giving me the opportunity to play this year, and I'm looking forward to 2013. Thank you.
Where's Mike Trout? He's got right here. Look at this young man. I'm glad, you know, I don't know how we missed you. Hey, Ruben, you know, like, you know, you know, like, what happened? You better start spending less time in South America, more time in South Jersey.
You're the only offensive lineman in Eagles history to catch 2 touchdown passes. So then would you join me, please, in welcoming the Philadelphia Sports Writers Association's Good Guy of the Year and finally putting a face to the anonymity of the man behind the face mask, number 79 of the Eagles, Todd Herremans.
Well, we all know that the Good Guy Award is the only thing that trumps the outstanding athlete, so. Keep working. Maybe next year.
There's one Eagle here. Herremans is here. Is he still around? Yeah, he's right here. What's up, brother? How you doing? Yeah, you guys don't usually come to this, but.
Any successful person will tell you that you can't be successful without a supportive wife, and I have one of the best, Mimi. We just celebrated our 43rd wedding anniversary. Half of them were very happy years.
Thank you very much. I'm thankful that I came after Joe Conklin so he wouldn't have an opportunity to say anything about me.
It's the biggest story in Philadelphia since John Street paid his gas bill, really.